New information on a story we first brought you last night. KCRA 3 has uncovered new information about how many people are living without lights on their streets because of copper wire thefts. The Night Team's Danielle Lee tells us that the city says thousands of people could be in the dark and they just can't keep up with all the work, Danielle.
Colson, you know, the city tells me that on average they're getting up to 5 calls a week about streetlights going out. They say it's all because thieves are breaking into these boxes and stealing out the copper wiring. They say the damage can take just minutes, but it can take days to make the repairs.
So I called in and the city didn't do anything about it.
Vanessa Prado says she hasn't had streetlights outside her home on Altos in Sacramento for months, ever since thieves ripped out the copper wiring.
And there's like no way you can see.
Vanessa isn't the only one in the dark. KCRA 3 obtained a list from the Department of Transportation of about 175 areas in the city without streetlights due to copper wire thefts.
And they can be without streetlights for 3 to 6 months. That's how backlogged we are.
Linda Tucker is with the Transportation Department, and she says they've already set aside nearly $500,000 for repairs related to thefts this year. They've already spent close to half of that.
They're working weekends, nights, everything to try and make a dent in the backlog.
This street light on Redding Avenue just got repaired by the city, and now it has this new special lock box. It's steel instead of cement, so you can't crack it open, and it has 2 special locking bolts that make it that much harder to pry open. A city services employee tells me they haven't had any thefts out of these new special boxes. But he says right now they only have enough money to install them in less than 1,000 of the more than 37,000 lights in the city.
We definitely sympathize with the residents who are in the dark, and we just ask for your patience.
Tucker tells me the department may even need to go to the council and ask for additional money early next year to keep making these repairs. She's also asking anyone who sees someone working on streetlights that is not wearing a city badge and is not driving a city car to call police. Reporting live in Sacramento, Danielle Lee, KCRA 319.
Yeah, people have to keep a lookout for those folks. Now, other cities have similar problems. Roseville estimates that the streetlight copper theft has cost them nearly $54,000. That's about a quarter of the losses Sacramento has experienced.